100,000 subscribers. Unbelievable. I started posting weekly on YouTube starting from around January 2017. Now, why weekly? Well, the original reason is actually a bit selfish. It was a way for me to get better at making online video. I knew it's something I really wanted to do, but I was so bad. I was really bad at talking to the microphone, to the camera. I loved giving classroom style training, and I thought it's going to be a piece of cake talking to my computer. I mean, I talk to myself all the time, but it wasn't easy. Here's a clip from my first video. The main mechanics of all these methods is conditional formatting, and it's a great feature that can bring a lot of value very quickly. Looks like I'm crying. If you want to get good at something, you just have to do it over and over and over again, right? Making online courses wasn't enough practice for me. I'm not such a fast learner in that respect. I wanted my courses to be good, so I had to practice somewhere else. That was the idea behind YouTube. Since then, that's how the channel's developed. Now I do it for a whole different reason. It's about the community. It's about learning and being inspired to learn more. Your comments and feedback are my inspiration. At the beginning, I managed to answer to every single comment. Now I try to do my best, but I read all comments. So let's use this opportunity to get to know each other a little bit. I'd love it if you can comment below and tell me a little bit about yourself, maybe your current profession, what your goals and plans are, anything you want to share, just comment below. I'm going to share a bit about myself. Actually, I'm going to take you on a quick tour. Come with me. I've been living in Vienna, the capital city of Austria, for the last 18 years. Although I did go to an English school here when I was a kid. It's a beautiful city and I really enjoy living here. Actually, 9 years in a row, Vienna's been number one in Mercer's Quality of Living Survey. It's located by the Danube River. It's very artsy and has a lot of history. It's a fairly big city with great infrastructure and public transport that's pretty much always on time. Unless, of course, you're in a hurry and need to be somewhere on time. But seriously, it rarely happens that they're not on schedule. There are also plenty of green areas and even vineyards within the city limits. I love it that there is always something happening, like Christmas markets, festivals, and concerts. Prior to this, I spent 5 years in Canada. I studied economics at Carleton University in Ottawa and my master's at the University of Toronto. Now, afterwards, I started to work as an economist at the Center for the Study of Living Standards in Ottawa. My main focus there was research for publications in academic journals, but I soon realized it's not for me. And the other thing that wasn't for me was that weather. I remember it got once super cold in January in Ottawa, and I wouldn't leave my apartment for an entire week, not even to go to the supermarket, which was across the street. I just had rice and potatoes all week long. But it was at this point, back in the year 2000, that I got in touch with Excel, and I struggled a lot with it at the beginning, but I constantly learned and I was amazed at what it can actually do. Excel and VBA remained my main tools over the next 15 years in the corporate world. Since 2015, I'm pursuing my passion to teach. Now, at first, it was all offline, and then I started my YouTube channel and my online courses. It's the most fulfilling job I've ever had. And job is not really the right word because it definitely doesn't feel like a job. Sometimes I just start up my computer in the morning and before I know it, it's already late afternoon. It's as if I stepped in a time capsule. It's crazy. What do I do when I'm not working? Well, I spend time with my family and friends. I do some sports. I treat myself to a wonderful bowl of chips with yogurt with a bit of salt and pepper. It's a treat I took over from my dad. I also like to watch series. So let's see if you can guess which one of my favorite series this is. Here's a hint. Comment below if you know it. What can you expect from me in the future? Well, I'm currently working on content for new courses. You probably know I'm super excited about dynamic arrays. And a new course on these awesome new functions is going to be out once Microsoft rolls it out to Office 365, so hopefully soon. I'm also working on an Excel basics course, and I also want to create a visualization and storytelling with data course, which was requested by many of you, and it's a topic I really love. And I also continue to create the tutorials for my YouTube channel, just like you've suggested in my previous videos. While Excel will always be a cornerstone for me in the coming months, I want to go further. I'm currently collaborating on a course where we're going to focus on business-related topics like accounting, investments, and other financial analysis. I've worked many years myself in the finance department, but my focus was always on the technical aspect of things, like making sure the consolidation logic worked fine in the system, and making sure that management got the reports that they wanted out of the system. So I feel like bringing the knowledge of a finance and accounting expert together with the technical knowledge from my side can make a valuable course. It's taking some time to set it up, and it's still a long way to go, but I'm super excited about it. So stay tuned. Make sure you sign up to my newsletter if you haven't done so already. I send an email about once a month updating you on the latest. So talking about the latest, I'd love to meet you at an upcoming Excel event. There's going to be an Excel summit on May 15th in Amsterdam. A link to the event is going to be in the description below. I'm going to be holding two sessions there. There are going to be great speakers like Oz, Boriana, Gasper, Liam, and Shandu. How cool is that? There's so much to do, and I really feel like this is just the beginning. You're the reason I was able to reach 100,000 subscribers on YouTube. Thank you for your support.